everybody. Good morning and welcome back to my channel. If you're new here, welcome. Thanks for being here. Happy Friday. So I don't normally start off vlogs. I don't normally start off vlogs on a Friday, but I thought why not? I'm in a good mood today and I have some fun stuff going on this weekend. So I'll just kind of vlog for the next few days. But I wanted to show you guys my outfit. I went to Target yesterday with Kathy. If you guys follow her, Miss Kellogg's Bunch, we went to Target yesterday and they have so many cute sweaters out, you guys. And I actually went outside my comfort zone and I got two sweaters that were like colorful. I bought this like green color one and then a blue one, and I'm obsessed. Also, I went to Starbucks this morning and they have their holiday drinks out. So this is the caramel brulee latte. So good. So yeah, the bell just rang. My kids are about to come in, but I just wanted to start off this video and yeah, I'll talk to you guys soon. Ready to come to the carpet and show the rest of the class how it's done. Does anyone want to start us off this morning on a really good note? Table three, come on over. Hey guys, just wanted to check in with you guys. We are on our lunch break right now. Today's been a really good day. It's been a long week, but it is finally Friday, so I'm just really excited for this weekend. I think there's someone outside my door doing something, but really exciting. I just ordered a new phone. I talked about it over, I told you guys over on Instagram, but I just ordered the new iPhone 13 Pro Max, which I'm really excited about. It's like the really big one, which I've never had any of the Maxes. I have the 11. My cute little niece on my screen. I have the iPhone 11 and I actually just got this iPhone, I think for my birthday, but there was a deal that I could get like $800 off the new phone with my service provider that I have. So I jumped on that. And so I'm getting a brand new phone. And I don't know if I told you guys, but I got a new laptop as well. I used to have a really old Mac that I got in 2014 when I graduated high school and it literally died on me. Like I literally opened it up and I had like the screen of death, I think they call it. It's just like a dark screen and it just never came back on again. So I got a new laptop. This is the MacBook Pro 13 inch, I believe. And then I just got like a cute case for it from Amazon. But yeah, I love it. I just felt like it was time to update all of my electronics because I spend most of my life on my electronics. I do most of my work, all of my work on my electronics, my camera, my laptop, and my phone. I bring with me everywhere and I literally do all of my work on them. So it's very crucial for me to have a laptop and phone that work really well. And for some reason, my last laptop that I had just had like so many viruses. And I swear guys, I don't click on anything. Like I don't click on these viruses. I don't know how it happened to my computer. They just happened out of nowhere. My last phone that I have did that too. But all I know is my phone started going slower. My laptop started going slower. And eventually it's like they just stopped working. So the new devices that I got, I knew I just wanted to take extra precautions and really take care of them, both my phone and my laptop, and make sure that they stay working as functional as they are when I first got them, meaning no blocks, ads, pop-ups, viruses, anything that is just slowing down my internet and my overall usage of my computer. And so that's why I started using Surfshark VPN, and they are the sponsors of this video. They are awesome. So excited to be partnering with them on this video. Surfshark VPN stands for a virtual private network, and they essentially keep your online identity safe by encrypting all of the information sent between your device and the internet. And that just keeps your personal personal data protected from big companies or cyber criminals. Also, a VPN can swap the real location of your device to anywhere in the world, aka that just means it changes your IP address if you're like a tech whiz and you know what that stuff means. That way you can virtually travel to anywhere around the globe. I am always using public Wi-Fi, and that's just like a goldmine for hackers, and I have a feeling me constantly using other people's Wi-Fi is where I started getting all these viruses on my last laptop that I had. So Surfshark's clean web will completely block any ads or phishing attempts, pop-ups, and it just allows you to use the internet safely. Surfshark doesn't like monitor or track or keep record of anything that you do on your computer. It's all very private. So I just feel super safe using it because it masks my IP address, which is essential to becoming private online. A VPN essentially makes sure that your city, country, and your download history aren't public or linked to your identity. Surfshark has 3,200 servers in 65 countries, and it allows you to access and unblock content libraries and streaming services from other countries, like all of Netflix libraries. It allows you to bypass censorship everywhere. So Surfshark liberates your internet by unblocking blocked websites and bypassing geo restrictions. Surfshark is offering a 30-day money-back guarantee so that you can try it out and see if you like it. So there's no risk trying it out. And I know I personally feel so much safer. I know many of you have jobs, whether you are working from home or maybe your job is on the internet, and so you're always on your laptop or using the internet. So I really think this could benefit a lot of you as well. Not only that, but Surfshark is offering my subscribers 83% off and 4 extra months free, completely free, if you use the code Madison at checkout. I will have the link in the description box below if you'd like to check it out. But yeah, so today's been going really good, and I'm just so excited, you guys, for holiday breaks coming up. Like, we're getting there. Like, we are entering the second trimester next week. My classes just come such a long way. We have parent-teacher conferences next week, and I will be filming all of that. And those videos might already be up at this point. Just depends when this video goes up. But my kids have just made so much progress, and I just love my class so much. Also, I got my nails done yesterday. They're a little crazy. If you can see, they're just like an almond-shaped, kind of like ombre French nail. They're cute. They're like, they're just a little much. Like, it's not exactly what I wanted. They're like super pointy, but it is what it is. It's just nails. So I'll get them done again in a couple weeks. Hey guys, it is the end of the day and I am about to head home, but I wanted to mention that today was a really good day and we got our foster grandparent today, which, if you don't know what that is, it's just a program where older people can sign up to come to the schools and come to classrooms and help out. And so I have an older woman that came in and she's gonna be in our classroom Monday through Wednesday and just help out. They can help with students or anything that the teachers need. And so it's been really nice having her in the classroom just to help out with anything and pull students if I need her to. My team and I were talking about that today. We were like, how nice would it be if every single teacher in the world could get at least one person to be in their classroom during the day and just help out. Like, how much that would help teachers, I don't think people even would understand. Like, my foster grandparent was even saying to me today, she was like, I don't know how you get anything done, because she's like, you're just one person and it seems like you're doing 10 things at once all the time, and every time you sit down to help a student, another one needs help and another one. And I'm like, I get it, girl. Like, it's yeah, that's every day, and that's why sometimes this job does feel impossible.
and I wish more people would come in and like observe classrooms and see, you know, what teachers do on a daily basis, and you know how hard it is to help every single student in your classroom whenever you just have another one lined up right behind them that need help. So it's really nice to have someone in there that can help the student that needs help, pull students out in the hallway, or just sit down with them and work with them. I mean, just literally one other person would help, let alone like if we could get like two people in a classroom, that'd be so, so helpful. But anyway, I'm about to go home and I don't really know what we're doing tonight. All I know is I have Kathy's baby shower on Sunday, which I'm so excited for, and I'll bring you guys along with me, and I'm gonna help her like set up and decorate and all that, which will be really fun. And yeah, I'll just bring you guys along with me this weekend. Guys, I'm not gonna lie, I definitely came home, changed into sweatpants, and have been on the couch ever since. It's been like 3 hours, and I did manage to edit a whole video, so I'm kind of productive. I'm not alone though, don't worry, Nala is lounging with me. We are just cuddling, right? Did you miss me? And yeah, I'm just chilling. And then Kyle will be home in like an hour, and I'm sure we're gonna do something tonight. I think we're just gonna have some friends over and hang out, but I'm kind of thinking about taking a nap. By Fridays, I am so exhausted. Like, it's actually crazy. Mondays, I have so much energy just from getting all like so much rest over the weekend. It's crazy how much more rested I feel after just 2 days off. But after a full 5 day week, I know it's like first world problems, but after a full 5 day week of working and waking up at 5:45 in the morning every day, and then I'm just like tired. I am so worn out. I need a break. I need a vacation, but we're a couple months away from a vacation, so a nap we'll just have to do for now. So I think me and Nal are just gonna nap together. She's like the best cuddle buddy because she's the type, she just like spoons you, like she just curls up right next to you and spoons you like a little human. So that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna lay down and just take a nap. Good morning, guys. It's the next day. It's Saturday. Last night we just ended up going to our friend's house, and we just made dinner, had some drinks. It was really fun. But I'm so excited because this is the first Saturday in like a really long time that I have absolutely zero plans. Like, I don't need to be anywhere. I don't need to do anything. I don't really have any work to do. I could edit a few videos, but nothing that's like super time sensitive or anything. And so I slept until 10, which just feels so good. If you know me, you know that's like easy for me. Like, I can sleep until 10 every day if I wanted to. And now I am just doing my skincare routine, washed my hair, took like a long shower, it was so nice. I exfoliated my whole body, I shaved. Oh, I wanted to show you, I used this new product. This is the Way Scalp and Body Scrub. I had been seeing it around. This isn't sponsored or anything, but I had been seeing it around, and so I really wanted to get it. Honestly, it was like the packaging that really got me. I just feel like it's so like chic, and oh guys, it smells so good. I can't even explain how good it smells. You just need to get it for yourself. I heard someone say that it smells good, but that's one of like the best smelling things I've ever put on my body. So I'm definitely gonna be rebuying that because it also goes on so smooth. Like, I've had exfoliators that just go on like sandpaper and it just like hurts and then it's like hard to wash off. But that one, it has like moisturizer, some type of moisturizer in it, to where it goes on like really smooth and washes off really smooth. So I love that. I'm just going in with some vitamin C on my face. I've been putting vitamin C on my face every day for a really long time because I just heard that it's really good for your skin, so I do it now. So yeah, I don't have any plans today, which is so nice. I'm just going to chill around the house. I have a couple errands that I would like to run. A couple days ago I did a huge deep clean of my closet and my like nightstand, my drawers and stuff like that, with like all my clothes in it. And I got rid of so much stuff, which feels so good. I'm the type of person where I love to purge. Like, I love getting rid of stuff, and I think I get it from my mom. Mom, if you're watching this, I feel like I grew up and my mom was like always just like getting rid of clutter. Like, she didn't like clutter either. And I'm the same way. I can't stand having things that I'm not using, whether that's like clothes that I'm not wearing, like shoes that I'm not wearing, or just like things that I'm not using. And so if I go too many months without doing like a deep purge of my closet. I feel myself getting like stressed out like every day when I open it and I see like all these clothes that I don't even wear anymore. They're just taking up all this space. So I came home from work the other day because I've been thinking about it all day. It was just the delivery guy, but that like scared me. When you guys are home alone, do you get like scared whenever you hear a knock on the door or like a man's voice? I get so scared. And he knocked really weird, and then I think he said delivery or something, which I'd rather them just like not talk, like just drop off the package, because if I'm home alone, I will like I'll be scared. But luckily I have Nala girl. Did you hear her barking like right away? If she hears like a peep, especially if I'm home alone, like if Kyle's here, I swear she doesn't get as like protective. But when I'm home alone, because I said this in the other vlog, I lived alone in college, just me and Nala for a while, and she became like so protective over me. And so now if she hears like a peep downstairs, she will go crazy and start like barking like crazy, especially if anyone like knocks on the door, speaks outside. If she hears a man's voice like outside or anything like that, she goes crazy. So I had to go like comfort her because she like is really stressed out. But she's just protective over her mom, so I appreciate that. Okay, I'm done with my skincare, and I'm not gonna go in with this quite yet. I wanna let my hair dry a little bit more, but I also got one of the Way leave-in conditioners. It just looks like this, very similar packaging to the body scrub. I actually haven't smelled this one yet. I kinda wanna smell it. It smells really good. It smells a little bit different than that one, but it smells really good. So I'm gonna wait until my hair's a little bit more damp than wet, and I'm gonna spray this like all the way through. And I heard that this stuff is like really good. I was listening to the Taylor Swift 1989 playlist whenever I was just showering. I don't remember when this came out. I think it was like 2015 or 16. It was after I graduated high school, but I remember like jamming out to this playlist every single day. Like I would just go on like long drives and listen to this playlist over and over and over again. So I know like every single word to every single song. And honestly, I'm not even like a huge diehard Taylor Swift fan. Don't come for me if you are. I know a lot of teachers are for some reason, but I never was like a diehard fan. Like I liked her, but not like that much. But that album came out and whoo, I don't know why I was obsessed with it, and I still am. I still play it all the time when I'm feeling like nostalgic and I just want to like drive around town, and it gives me like fall vibes. So every time like the seasons change, I listen to Taylor Swift and like drink my pumpkin spice latte. I'm so weird. Okay, I'm done with my skincare. Now I was gonna change, but I might just hang out in my robe for a little bit. Yes, it's me. It's been over an hour and I'm still in my robe. And my hair's still wet. I've just been down here doing some work. I mean, it doesn't feel like work. Social media really is my job, but I love doing it, and that's why I allow myself to do it on the weekends. Because it's fun for me. I enjoy it. I wouldn't let myself do it if I didn't enjoy it. But Kyle isn't home because he is out hunting again. It's bow season, and he is a big hunter. I am not, hence why I'm home in my robe in my warm house, because I think he's just crazy for sitting in a deer stand for 7 hours in 30 degree weather. I could not do it, and yeah, just bless him, bless his heart for wanting to do that. And he has been off this month of November. If you guys didn't know, Kyle is in medical school, and he's currently in his fourth year of medical school. He graduates in May, and so he's applying for residencies, going through that whole process, and it's really exciting. But he has this month off for interviews, and so he's had a lot more free time than normal, which I'm very happy for him because he hasn't had free time in 4 years. And so this is a big deal for him to have a month off. He still has interviews every now and then, but he has been really taking advantage of it and taking time for himself. And so he has been doing what he loves, which is hunting and being in the woods and all that boy stuff. So he's out doing that while I'm here chilling. So it's just me and Nala girl most of today. And then, yeah.
Okay, these are the packages I just got in the mail. I got Teacher Style Box, and then I got another one from Gray Bandit, which I'll show you. I'm just covering my address right now, but I'm super excited about these. Okay, first from Teacher Style Box, I got this super pretty dress. If you guys are not familiar with Teacher Style Books, it's a monthly subscription and you get at least 2 pieces of clothing a month. Sometimes, depending on how fast you return them, you can get up to 4 or 5 or 6 pieces of clothing. But I love it so much. I always wear their pieces to school and they're perfect to wear as a teacher. So this would be really cute to wear with like a cardigan to school. It's a little fancy. I might wear it on parent-teacher conferences next week. The other piece that came in my package was this super cute striped cardigan. It's so thick and soft and I love that it's so long. You guys know I love wearing cardigans, so this is perfect. This is something I would definitely purchase, so I'm very excited to wear this as well. Next up, I ordered a few pieces from Gray Bandit. Okay, I'm so sad. I ordered these cute jeans from them, but they're actually a little bit too small, so I just tried them on. I'm gonna have to return them, which this always happens to me. Jeans are the hardest thing to fit my body. I have big hips, a little waist, really long legs, a big booty, so it's sometimes just really hard to find jeans that fit me perfectly. I don't know why I still buy online, because then I just always have to return them, but that's okay. I'm just gonna have to return these. Next up, I got this super cute kind of like turtleneck cropped long sleeve. I thought this would be perfect. Just, I don't know, for like fall, winter days. You could wear it honestly for any type of occasion. I could wear this to school with a jacket over it and some high-waisted jeans. I could wear this on like an event or like Thanksgiving. I could just wear this around the house. I just love pieces like this that are super simple, just a staple to have. This next piece is super basic, but I always am in need of more just like white tanks, and I love these like razorback ones. They're just so cute, and yeah, that's pretty much the only reason why I got it, because I love them. I am so excited about this sweater. It has these huge like bubble sleeves. I love this color, this cream color. I love the detailing on the seams. I saw Vivian Audie wearing this on Instagram, if you guys follow her. She works with Gray Bandit a lot, and so she's kind of the one that inspired me to shop there. By the way, I got this in a size large just because I like my stuff really big and oversized, and this would be so cute to teach in over leggings or jeans. The last and final thing that I got is this beautiful kind of like cropped pullover sweater. I just love this like burnt, it's kind of like an orangey brown color. I got it in a size medium, so it's a little bit oversized, but I didn't want it like too big because it is still supposed to be like cropped. Yeah, I just thought this would be so cute with some jeans. This is the bag of clothes that I am donating. I know it doesn't look like a lot, but it's actually a super big garbage bag, and I had a second garbage bag filled to the top that I threw away. The other bag that I threw away was just stuff that was either like kind of like old, had holes in them, had stains on them, just something I knew no one would want. But this I am donating today. Guys, I totally forgot to show you, but I just got in the mail yesterday these boots. Oh, I am in love with them. They are just suede booty heels, obviously. These are from Steve Madden. They were quite the penny, pretty penny, but they are so beautiful, and I have been eyeing them for a couple months now, and so I decided to just get them because I knew I could wear them in the holiday season coming up. I wouldn't wear these to school, too fancy and too high of a heel, but for like holidays or just even going out at night with some like skinny jeans or leather leggings and a sweater. Ooh, so cute. So yeah, I'm obsessed. Okay, I didn't film it. I probably should have, but I just went through my closet and organized all of my shoes. So down here at the bottom, I have like sneakers, sandals, a few, like down here I keep my staples, like what I'm currently wearing. But up at the top, it honestly was just so cluttered. This like shelf goes back super far. I can't even reach back there, so I was just like throwing shoes that I didn't wear anymore back there. So I was like, you know what, if I'm not wearing them and I can't even see them, what's the point of having them? So it was just shoes that I was like, maybe I'll wear one day. So I decided, I just went through and I took all of them out. And so these are them. So honestly, they're just all boots that I don't wear anymore. Like, I used to wear these all the time in college, just like the tall suede boots. These ones I've had forever. I mean, for probably like 4 or 5 years. And I'm just kind of over them. So what you see up top is what I kept. I just kept these like black booties. I actually just got these. They're so cute for going out at night. Just big, chunky black boots. I always wear these when I go out at night.
black Uggs. These are just high-heeled black suede boots, basically just these in black. And then these are the ones I just showed you. I think every closet needs some sort of like heeled booty, either like suede or leather. And then these are my beloved Steve Madden little booties that I got last fall. I love them so much. And then I just have these cute little leather booties from Amazon. Like I said, down here is just what I'm currently wearing. So I'm always wearing my Converse, you know, always wearing my Nikes. And now that it's fall, I've started to pull out my leather boots, my Steve Madden ones. And then these ones were thrifted. These are my workout shoes, so I pull them quite often. And then these I wear around the house. Then this shoe rack just holds all of my other like tennis shoes, sandals down at the bottom, just maybe shoes that I don't wear as often or if they're out of season. It feels so good to purge and I cannot wait to get a bigger closet one day, but honestly it's probably good for me to have a small closet because then it makes me want to purge. All of those empty hangers used to have clothes on them, so this used to be way more full, and then we have a second closet in our second bedroom that I may or may not have filled with more clothes. So this originally was supposed to be Kyle's closet. He has a closet in our room, but this was supposed to be like for his work clothes, which he does keep a lot of his like fancy work clothes in here, but I kind of took over with all of my sweatshirts because these just take up so much space. I didn't have room for them in my other closet, so now I hang up all of my hoodies and sweatshirts and I try to color coordinate them. And then as time went on, I started putting more of my like fancy dress clothes back here that I just don't wear as often, but I didn't want to get rid of them, so I just keep those back there. Okay, it's time. My hair is damp, and as you can see, I have crazy hair. So this is me like not brushing it, and so I have to go through with a conditioner and brush it, otherwise this is what we're working with. So if you're a curly haired girl, you know how it is. But I'm gonna go in with this Way leave-in conditioner, spray it all over, and then comb it out. Left Plato's Closet. If you guys aren't familiar, Plato's Closet is a thrift store here in Columbia where you can donate and sell your clothes. So I decided just to take my clothes there to donate, but it's kind of nice because you get some money back for them. So I got $95 back, which was really nice. They took every single pair of those shoes besides these ones, which it's always so fun to me, the shoes that they don't take, because these are brand new ASOS shoes, high heels. The reason I don't wear them is just because the heel's a little bit too high for me and they were just always uncomfortable. But brand new, I literally have never worn them out in public, just tried them on and they didn't take them. And then they didn't take a few of my other clothes, it looks like, just like a couple of my dresses, a couple shirts it looks like, but they took a ton of my stuff, which is always nice. And then like I said, I got like $95, so it's a win-win. So I just am going to take that to probably Goodwill just to donate the rest of the items that they didn't take. But while I waited, I went, as you guys saw, I went to Tropical Smoothie Cafe, which is one of my favorite places to eat, and they have the best smoothies. This is the island green smoothie that I always get. I've shown it in vlogs before. And then I got the chicken pesto flatbread, which was so good.
But that took a long time. They're so busy on Saturdays, Plato's Closet, so it took over an hour for them to do my clothes, to like go through them. But now I'm gonna go home. Kyle's on his way home actually because he got a deer, so he's coming home a little bit early. So it's going on 3 o'clock, so I'm going to just head home. I just went to our mailbox and I had this package in the mail, and I remember a sweet girl messaged me on Instagram about a week ago and she wanted to send me a pair of leggings. She said I think her and her mom have a store and it's called L&M Made to Live In, and these are the comfort legging. I got them in a size medium and wow, I'm impressed. These are super thick and very soft. They feel just like Lululemon leggings, so I'm really excited to wear these. I can't remember her name, so if you message me on Instagram, please comment or message me again so I can thank you personally. But yeah, these are so cute. I'm so excited. All right, my next task is to tackle this beast. She is almost completely dry, just like still a little bit damp, but I like to go in with my blow dryer. I use this air blow dryer. I honestly don't remember the brand. It's like the Revlon one, but I got it off Amazon for super cheap. So it works the exact same way and it really does the job. So I'm not gonna show you guys the whole process because it takes me like 30 minutes to do this. So I'll just speed up for you guys and show you the satisfying after. And we're done. I wish it was that fast, but that actually didn't take me near as long since my hair was so already almost dry. It only took me about 15 minutes. But as you see, it just helps like really tone down my hair. It just gives it like a nice blowout look and it smooths it out and everything. And we're done with the baby shower. It was so much fun showering this baby. And yeah, we got a lot of footage, but go watch Kathy's video. She also has a channel, which I will have right here.
Yeah.
And she filmed like the entire day this morning and setting up like behind the scenes.
Yes.
Tons of really good footage. So go watch that if you're interested.
Yeah.
Did you have fun?
Yeah, it was so much fun, guys. Like I said, I was saying this earlier, but I'm 35 weeks now. And so we're just happy that we got out of the way. I'm so grateful
you're
for Madison.
Big.
I know. She literally helped with everything. She got all the decor. She got vlog footage. So we got to thank her for all of that.
I love that stuff.
I know.
So she's due, what, December 13th?
Yeah, December 13th.
So you're literally a month out.
Yeah, a month.
And baby's going to be here
soon. I
can't
believe it.
I know, I'm so excited. But I'm going to end this vlog here because it's getting really long. And yeah, so thank you for watching. Go follow Kathy if you don't already subscribe to her channel. By the way, don't forget to check out Surfshark. I will have it linked down below in the description box. And I will see you guys next time.